Hi, I'm Jo Bailey, and today I'm going to help you understand why that grossly incompetent person, perhaps the person you work with, maybe your neighbor, or perhaps you're married to them, thinks they're awesome. Before I begin, I want to give a quick thank you to those people supporting me on Patreon, where I can answer your clinical questions, and hoping to set up a group Zoom call soon. If you want to support me on Patreon, the link is below. But let's move on with today's video about the Dunning-Kruger effect. Okay, before we start, I want you to imagine that there is a group of 100 people, of which you are one. Now, I want you to imagine this group is divided into three sections. The lowest third is the below average group, the middle group, the average group, and then the highest third is the above average group. Now, if there are 100 people in this group, then presumably about 33% of the people will be in each of these categories. Now, I want you to imagine that you're going to rank yourself on this scale. So you're either going to be below average, average, or above average on the following criterias. You ready? First one is looks. Where do you put yourself on this scale? What about driving skills? For the parents watching, where would you put yourself on parenting skills? And what about your job? How good are you at that? What about intelligence? How about common sense? The next one is cooking. Are you below average, like me, or are you a superior cook? And the final one is musicality. Where would you rank yourself there? Now, according to the Dunning-Kruger effect, which I'll tell you more about in a moment, most of you, probably at least half of you, would have ranked yourself above average, because that's what happens with the Dunning-Kruger effect. This, of course, violates the rules of maths. We can't have more than 50% of you putting yourself into the highest category. That doesn't make sense. It was Socrates who said, "The only true wisdom is knowing when you know nothing." And that, in effect, is the Dunning-Kruger principle. Believing that you know something when really you don't. It's like the armchair sportsman who yells at the professional player because surely he could do better if given the chance. Or the 16-year-old who knows better than their parents or anyone else for that matter, even those that have a lot more life experience than them. The Dunning-Kruger effect was made known in 1999 by two social psychologists, David Dunning and Justin Kruger. And technically, it just describes what we call a cognitive bias, which is really just a faulty thinking style. And it suggests that people with low ability are going to overestimate their ability, and that people with high ability will underestimate their ability. Take, for instance, this criminal who made the news for all the wrong reasons in the state where I live, in Queensland, Australia. He decided to try and steal an ATM from a petrol station, gas station. He tried to use a chain from his ute and hook it up to the ATM. But he didn't realize that his chain had come loose and he actually drove off with nothing. But not to be deterred, he returned and he tried again. But this time his chain was too short and it was all too hard, and I guess he realized he wasn't the competent criminal that he thought he was. Now, I don't know, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Or what about this guy in a phone store in Asia? He had a foolproof plan. He went into the store, he was going to look at display phones, grab one and run. Guess he overlooked the fact that the phones are anchored with this recoiling wire, and when his attempt failed and gained the attention of the female worker, he seemed too embarrassed to do much except eat humble pie and sheepishly exit the store. And it's not just criminals that do this, it could be anyone in any life situation. And with people capturing the antics of others now more than ever before, with surveillance, mobile phones, and CCTV watching our every move, it's really hard to have a private moment of stupidity anywhere. You better be sure your high confidence and your low ability will spring up as a humorous meme or a shameful gif somewhere on the news or the internet. So if you think about those life areas that I listed just before, according to the Dunning-Kruger effect, those who actually underrated their ability, that is those of you who put yourself in the lower end of the rating scale, are more likely to be the ones who excel, assuming you have some experience in that area. Let me show you how this works. See, Dunning-Kruger effect is the interaction of both confidence and knowledge and experience. You can have enormous confidence but no experience, and that makes you a master of ignorance. Or you might have just a little bit of knowledge, not a lot, but heaps of confidence, and now you are Mr. Know-it-all, aka Mr. or Mrs. Stupid, because this applies to the ladies as well. Then you gain moderate knowledge or experience, and it's here that you come to realize that you really don't know as much as you thought that you did, and you slide down this slippery slope of confidence into a pit of despair. But this is also the moment that the penny drops. It's a turning point for you. Sure, there's some humble pie to eat as you slide down the slope of shame and embarrassment for being such a smarty pants, and they do say that pride comes before a fall, but at the bottom of this slope is the dawning of wisdom. So enjoy the ride. It gets better from here because you start to realize here that you don't know what you don't know. And you then are ready to begin your ascent up the hill of hope, the climb to enlightenment, which never really peaks, but it does reach a plateau of stability. See, the more you know, the more you realize how little you actually know. And that's when the confident fool has emerged from their cocoon as an experienced and knowledgeable and humble student of life. When you're unskilled, it's hard to see your own faults, but when you start to become exceptionally good at something, you may then fail to realize just how great you really are. So now that you understand how the Dunning-Kruger effect works, let's review those domains that I presented to you earlier. If you rated yourself at the lower end of that looks continuum, then you are probably more attractive than you realize, as humility and meekness can be very appealing to the opposite sex. On the other hand, if you think you are God's gift to mankind,
give me a cheer if you want me to take my shirt off. Are you sure? Yeah? Like this. Cheer louder. Wait, stop. Thank you. Thank you very much. Been amazing.
Every second of your existence should be captured on Instagram, because dare anyone miss a moment of your awesomeness, then yeah, you're probably experiencing cognitive bias or delusions of grandeur that place you at the peak of the Dunning-Kruger effect. Only place is down from there, unfortunately. What about driving skills? Well, the same principles apply. If you're only on your learners and you think you could outrace Ayrton Senna down Main Street, well then yeah, you're ready for a fall into that valley of despair. But if you have 40 years of driving experience under your belt, even with a couple of minor infringements which you've paid and learned from, then chances are you're on the road to being an expert, among your peers at least, and you'll be in that above average third. What about culinary skills? Well, when it comes to cooking, I couldn't cook to save my life. And yeah, I'm 50 years old and I've probably got a bit of experience, but saying I'm a good cook would be definitely an overstatement. I would certainly place myself in the below average range for this category. But then, you know, perhaps that means I'm a better cook than I'm giving myself credit for, because Dunning-Kruger effect, those that have knowledge and experience often underestimate their ability. I think I'll ask my kids. Hey, while you're here, let me ask you a question.
You bad.
Pop down here and hop in the video for a minute. I have a question to ask you. You have to pop down.
What?
Okay, you got to rate me on cooking.
Out of what?
Well, below average, average, or high average. On a scale of 100?
Minus 50.
Okay, go. Go, go.
Bye.
Well, at least I rated myself accurately. And we see the Dunning-Kruger effect alive and well in reality TV these days.
Yeah, wait a minute till I, oh yeah.
No comment.
Today, anybody could be bad to you. Need a good guy to blow your mind.
It never ceases to amaze me and amuse me how some of these people think they are experts in their field. I mean, either these are perfect examples of the Dunning-Kruger effect, or someone in their families are lying to them. Point is, most of you have probably fallen into the Dunning-Kruger trap and overestimated your ability. But those that have put themselves in the below average category along the way have probably underestimated their ability. And then there are a rare few, probably less than about 10%, that have rated themselves with a degree of accuracy. Research shows us that over 75% of people will rate themselves in that above average category, or the highest third. But you can't have 75% of people in a group that only holds 33%. And that's the Dunning-Kruger effect. So if you happen to be one of them, then here is some free advice for you. It's better to remain silent and be thought a fool than to open your mouth and remove all doubt. So now hopefully you have some insight into why some people who think they are the bee's knees but are really the turkey's tail think that they are so awesome. And if you do happen to know one of these people, be patient and be kind. Remember, the slope of despair awaits them, and whilst it can be very satisfying to watch them fall from grace, even the blissfully ignorant fools amongst us have human emotions, so compassion is always the preferred strategy. But it can be hard, so one final word of caution. When arguing with a fool, be careful the other person is not doing the same thing. That's all for now. Take care of yourselves and each other, and have a happy, peaceful day. Bye for now. Who is that?
Dunning.
Okay, Jax, I'm in the middle of a video. You're ruining it. And you think you could outrace. I don't even know. Famous racing driver. Dunning-Kruger effect. I have to Google it.
Bye.
Can I just do the rest of this, please? And whilst it can be quite satisfying to watch them fall from grace, it can be very satisfying. We shouldn't laugh. We should be kind. You're not being kind. Bad.